again, everybody, and welcome to Mid-South Wrestling. Another great hour of Mid-South Wrestling action in store for us. And, you know, we've got a lot of exciting things to talk about. Before we go into the card, I want to say welcome to Joel Watts, who will be here with me during the portion of this hour. Joel will be doing some color commentary. As you, many of you fans know, Joel is the 20-year-old son of Cowboy Bill Watts. And Joel, it's great to have you here. I know you've been around this business a long time, ever since you were a little guy, and it's great to be here with you.
Well, yeah, Jim, I'm real happy to be here myself. You know, it seems like professional wrestling has its finger on the pulse of the youth of America more than any other sport in the nation right now. And I just like being around all the excitement, and I just love it. I've always, ever since I was a kid, I've been going to the matches and watching the matches, and I just like them more than anything. And as you know, the Rock and Roll Express just got through winning the Mid-South Tag Team belts. I think they'll probably represent the Mid-South a lot better than the former holders of it, the Midnight Express. And I just happened to put together a video on them.
I tell you what, Joel, before we show that video, we want to remind everyone once again that we had a last week just a touch of our Super Date that we're going to be doing, the Super Date and the Superdome. Of course, the next Superdome extravaganza will be in, of course, New Orleans at the Superdome on June the 16th. Tickets are now on sale at all Ticketmaster outlets and at the Superdome. It's going to be a great time for two young ladies, a very special evening I'm sure they'll never forget. We will tell you more about the Super Date and, of course, how to enter. One thing to do, I want to remind all the young ladies, if they're 18 years of age or more and not married, to send in the very best picture that you can, because, of course, an independent agency will be judging those, and it should be a very exciting time. You know, ladies and gentlemen, at this point in time, I want to let you know that all the great videos that we see here, the MTV-like videos, Joel has produced those. They've been some exciting things. And Joel, I know you're very proud, and I'm sure the people are going to be very excited to see the one you've done on the Rock and Roll Express. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, I put it together with the music Jump by Van Halen, which seems to be a pretty popular song. And during the recording of it, I was hanging out the window of our van with a camera, and we were pulled over by a Tulsa County sheriff who thought that I had some kind of weapon or something. You'll see a small portion of that, and I just hope you like it.
I think they'll love it. I think it's the best we've ever had here on Mid-South. Let's see that video now. It's the Rock and Roll Express with a little help from Van Halen.
I get up.
Rock and Roll Express won the Mid-South Tag Team titles here last week, and that was a great personal look at them with a little help from Joel Watts and Van Halen and some great music. But you know, some other exciting things here happened last week, and some very unpredictable things, namely the painting, the yellow painting of Stagger Lee by Hacksaw Butch Reed, and of course Nature Boy Buddy Landell was involved in that situation. Stagger Lee has left Mid-South, ladies and gentlemen. He said he came here to help Cowboy Bill Watts and earn some serious money. Well, he got paid his money from Cowboy Bill Watts, and he says that they were mad at the Junkyard Dog for the reason that he got painted, and that the Junkyard Dog's got him in a lot of problems. Well, we'll hear from the Junkyard Dog because he will be here later in this hour. He won't be wrestling, but he will give us an update as just exactly where he has been and some of the great matches that he will be featured in around the country. So, Joel, I know we're both excited about hearing from the Junkyard Dog.
Oh, definitely so, Jim. It's been quite a while since I've seen the dog.
Well, the Junkyard Dog will be here. We've got a great hour, including the Rock and Roll Express coming up next, and we'll be back with that great match after this word from the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. Ladies and gentlemen, you know the Rock and Roll Express are the new Mid-South Tag Team Champions. And one thing I can make this statement, I think, very, very honestly, and it's speculation. It's really not speculation. They took the titles from Jim Cornette's Midnight Express. And as we all know, you can't take Jim Cornette lightly. He's a very devious individual. And while the Midnight Express were the Tag Team Champions, a great combination was in the Mid-South area called the Bruise Brothers. And Troy Graham's leg was broken by the Midnight Express, and we have some footage now we'd like to show you, an interview with the Bruise Brothers outside the Memphis Hospital. Let's play that now.
First of all, I'd like to say thank you for all the hundreds and hundreds that you can see here of cards and letters that have poured into the hospital from all the Mid-South wrestling fans wanting to know how my Bruise Brother number one is, and I think he's got something he'd like to say to you right now.
Well, the rains will come and the winds will blow, but the Bruise Brothers spread sunshine everywhere to go. But I'm not spreading too much sunshine now, as you can plainly see. You know, I laid up in that hospital for quite a few weeks there, and I just had a lot of things run over and over in my mind, and all I could think about was the Midnight Express. But you know, Midnight Express, I've never intentionally hurt anyone this bad just to go out and deliberately break their leg. But you know, I guess behind every cloud there's a silver lining, and I will be coming back to the Mid-South wrestling area. And I want to tell you something, Midnight Express, I will be looking for you.
You know, like you said before, man, the man's got a plate in his ankle, two pins. It might be 6 months, it might be 9 months, it might be a year, but I promise you this, baby, the Midnight Express and Cornette, don't you send Bruise Brothers and Jimmy Hart no flowers, because we ain't dead yet. And when you least expect it, Cornette, from me to you, baby, we will get even.
Those are some strong comments from Troy Graham. And ladies and gentlemen, a severely broken leg. We don't know exactly how long he will be out of action. Some speculate it could be up to 1 year. A very severe break at the hands of the Midnight Express. So the Rock and Roll Express certainly can't take Jim Cornette lightly. And speaking of the Rock and Roll Express, they're up next. Let's go to the ring and Boyd Pierce.
This event, wrestling fans, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, the team of Pat Rose and Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Gibson and Ricky Martin, the Rock and Roll Express.
Rock and Roll Express, the new Mid-South Tag Team Champions here, making their first appearance since winning the Mid-South titles here last week on television, going against Pat Rose and Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Referee Carl Fergie will be the third man, or the fifth man in the ring, as it were. The Rock and Roll Express. Joe, I know you've spent a lot of time with these two young men, and they are just a dynamite pair of young guys and an awesome tag team combination.
They sure are, Jim. You know, they're excitement plus. They've got moves that they're just so slick on their feet. They remind me a lot of the great amateurs at the lighter weights that, you know, they don't go out and particularly devastate their opponents with size and mass. They just use their speed and their ability and quickness.
Good maneuver by Ricky Morton. High hip toss and Pat Rose drop kick. Morton with a lightning quick arm drag. That takeover, and they are, you know, another thing, Joe, they have worked together so much that they really know what their partner is thinking at all times.
Yes, they've got tag team wrestling down to a science, that's for sure.
Armbar by Robert Gibson, the taller of the two of the Rock and Roll Express.
You know, when you're taller like that, you can usually get a lot more leverage, and Robert Gibson certainly knows about leverage.
Another arm drag. Look at the leverage he's executing there, stepping over the man, utilizing every bit of leverage and strength that he does possess in that arm bar against Pat Rose. Legal tag. Morton, a pinning predicament here. Referee Carl Fergie with a two count. And here comes the arrogant one, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, who will attempt to slow things down, it would appear.
Yeah, but he may just get humbled by Ricky Morton.
Nightmare takeover, right back to the arm bar. You know, it's very interesting, and I think that your father has brought it to light better than anyone I've ever been around. Is wrestling's a lot like a game of human chess. You establish your strategy and stick with it, hopefully to a winning combination. And that they have started that strategy with those working on the upper part of the body of their opponents this match. Bull Nelson.
Right.
Referee will have to break that hold. And there's... That's one way of breaking it.
A little quick thinking there by Robert Goodson, something he's very good at. Buddy Landell takes the easy way out again. I've seen that happen more than once.
Pat Rose and Gibson sizing each other up. Side headlock. Well, we've got a lot of super matches, and of course we'll tell you more about the Super Date and the Superdome just later in this hour. Rose with those tackles and retaliating very perfectly, turning the hip toss to a pretty predicament, going back to the arm bar.
They're definitely trying to possibly damage Pat Rose's latissimus muscles.
Ricky Morton, perhaps the quicker of the two, if that could be judged. Pat Rose taking a shortcut. Those are illegal maneuvers there on that rope. Referee Fergie, very smart at going between the two men. I'll tell you one thing, though. Morton, he fights from the minute he gets there until the match is over.
He's got a lot of fire. That's
oh,
the trick.
Right to the post. Right to the post. That's a good way to break the collarbone. Morton was going for the kill, and he miscalculated. Rose moved out of the way, and that steel post is quite an adversary.
Boy, you're not kidding. And look at how Landell moves in. Boy, he's just like a shark when he gets in that ring. He smells blood, and he goes right after it.
Well, quite obviously, ladies and gentlemen, Landell realizes that arm has been damaged from that severe blow to that steel ring post.
But look at the heart Ricky Morton's got.
Referee caught Landell pulling the hair. Good job, good position by Fergie.
Gee whiz.
Morton is in a very, very deep predicament here with that That shoulder has taken a tremendous pounding, not only from his opponents, but from that post. And our packed house here at the Irish McNeil Boys Club exhorting Ricky Moore to make the tag, and there he's made it. Gibson working over both men.
Well, that Gibson's fresh. He is hard to beat. Terrific drop kick. Thundering right cross.
He is high elevation. Landale is in a bad way. There's the tag. Landale is out of his feet. Landale goes out on the floor. Rock and Roll Express doing what they do best. It's tag team, double drop kick. One, two, and three. And there's the winners. The people are standing there. You see the winners, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. And we'll be back with Terry Taylor after this word from the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. On my right in the red corner from New York, Randy Barber. And his opponent across the ring in the blue corner, Vero Beach, Florida, the popular Terry Taylor.
Ever popular Terry Taylor will be squaring off against Randy Barber here on Mid-South Wrestling. Referee Alfred Neely calls for the bell. Very popular Terry Taylor, quick go behind. Takedown, Randy Barber, the opponent.
You know, Jim, Terry Taylor's another guy that's got a lot of fire and is just a lot of excitement in the ring. He's the kind of guy that makes professional wrestling a lot of fun to watch.
He certainly does. And you know, I think that from the first time that he came here, the people, the chemistry was right from the minute he appeared in the Mid-South wrestling scene. He's a very charismatic young man. He really cares for the fans, and I think that the motivation that the fans give him perhaps means more to him than it does other wrestlers, because you know, that's just the type of person that he is. He always takes time to visit with the fans. That's very, very important for any athlete to do.
You know it, Jim, and not only the charisma, but what an athlete. A fantastic athlete. He's got a good amateur background. There's a perfect example of that. What a well-executed maneuver by Terry Taylor.
Terry Taylor in excellent condition. And, of course, he has had a severe time with some of the toughest adversaries in all of professional wrestling, namely Hacksaw Butch Reed, who tried to really put him out of wrestling, that pile driver to the floor here just a few weeks ago. And we saw, I think, perhaps one of the greatest displays of courage that any wrestler has ever exhibited when Taylor went to the ring against Crusher Khrushchev.
Well, you know, that display of courage is continuing right here, as you can see the neck brace on Terry Taylor. He obviously isn't letting it bother him too much now, is he?
Randy Barber knows that neck has been injured, and he'll try to take a shortcut or two.
I don't think Terry Taylor's going to let Taylor with that too long.
Boy, he thundered that forearm right to the jaw. That should be all for Barber, and it is. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner is Terry Taylor, and I'll be talking to the Junkyard Dog right after this word from the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. Ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed a pleasure for me to be here at ringside with one of the true legends of professional wrestling, a man that has cut his teeth right here in the Mid-South area and became a superstar from coast to coast. It's great to have you back, Junkyard Dog.
pleasure always be back. You know, I'd like to give thanks to all the people here throughout the Mid-South area because they gave me the strength, the endurance, plus my wife and kid. I've been very fortunate. You know, I've been throughout the world, Virginia, North Carolina. Just haven't had the big thing over in Texas. I'm in the Orange Bowl. But I couldn't have did it without the people in the Mid-South area. Now I'm rated number three throughout the world, and I'm out there representing the people.
I know you've been all over the world. Of course, I know another area you've been in, Memphis, Tennessee. A lot of exciting action happening there. You've just been everywhere, Atlanta.
Yeah. I've been in Memphis, Tennessee. I've been in Atlanta. I got to go to North Carolina pretty soon because a so-called Bigfooter in Atlanta trying to run a roughshod with a couple of fellows up there. I'm going to take care of business because I was built here in the Mid-South. I was more or less born here in the Mid-South. The people in the Mid-South just about raised the dog, and I'm going to do just about what they want me to do and take care of business throughout the world.
You know, Doc, when you left, Mid-South did not make you leave. You left on your own accord, and I want to know you want to clarify that.
Oh, yeah, I left on my own accord, and I said I would leave, and I did leave.
What are you doing out
Wait.
Breathe in my face, too.
No. I just personally don't know anybody that cares what he has to say.
Wait just a second. Wait just both of you gentlemen. First of all, this is his interview time, not yours. I don't know what business you have out here.
I'll tell you what business I've got. We got cheated. The Midnight Express got cheated out of the Mid-South Tag Team Championship. He's got no business being here. I want to get the Rock and Roll Express out here and have another title match to show everybody who the champions are. Because let me tell you something. You promised.
Don't blow in my face.
You've got no business being here. You promised that if you lost that match, you'd be out of Mid-South for 90 days. But what do? You put that stupid mask on and come back as stupid Stagger Lee and help stupid fathead ex-cowboy Bill Watts in his last stampede. But let me tell you something else. I was glad to see that Butch Reed come out here last week and paint that stripe down your back. I can still see the yellow showing because that's all you are is a yellow dog-faced liar.
You know what he just did? He just wrote a check that his rear end won't be able to...
Wait. The junkyard. Just wait. Ow!
Come here! I want to speak this time. I'm gonna make it so that no matter who he is, Stagger Lee. A junkyard dog, he got a mark that he can carry from now on, baby. He is a dog. He is a dog. Are you out of there, baby?
Well, as we're trying to get some order restored here in our packed Irish Mail Boys Club after that bizarre incident that just happened concerning the Junkyard Dog and that paint, Mr. Wrestling, the North American champion, has joined me here at Mike's side. And, Mr. Wrestling, I'm sure the fans are interested in knowing exactly when and your plans for the North American title, when your next title match will be.
Hey, listen, I'm not interested in when my next title is going to be, and you don't worry about it one way or the other. What I'm interested in is how the Rock and Roll Express got mine and my partner's robe and our thing without breaking into my car and getting it. Now, you answer that one. How'd they get that? That's a good question, right? Well, I'll tell you what. I'd like to have an opportunity also. I told you once, and I'll tell everybody out here right now, I'd like to get them in a ring right here on TV. Get them in a ring. They call themselves champions after trying to be Mr. Wrestling 1 and 2? No way.
Well
let me tell you. Well, what?
I can't answer those questions for you. You need to take up those matters with matchmaker Grizzly Smith. But ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Wrestling's new protege is standing by in the ring. Let's go now to Boyd Pierce.
This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit,
In the red corner, from parts unknown, Mr. Wrestling number two. And his opponent across the ring, 215 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Jason Wacker. Your referee, Alfred Neely.
Jason Wacker will have the task ahead of him to go against Mr. Wrestling 2.
A task you got right. Now you're going to see a man with skills unbelievable. He's a man that I have been working with for over 2 years. And I'll tell you something, a lot of people don't know anything about this. You look at that beautiful takedown he had. He's got a right on him, hooked at that hook, arm hook there, going in for... first thing they do, they go scrambling to the ropes. They can't get away, so they look for the easy way out.
Referee breaking the hold, but Mr. Wrestling 2 did not break legally.
Why should he? Man's trying to run away from him, stomping brains out. Beautiful slam, pick him right up there. Beautiful.
An awesome specimen indeed. Must weigh the neighborhood of 270, 275 pounds in perfect condition. Going against a very outmanned Jason Wacker.
He is a man that's not only in superb condition, in physical condition, but mental also. He's a man that respects his coach. He's a man that respects wrestling. He's a man that respects everything that's built around him, which, needless to say, me.
Oh, I know that you have mentioned that you wanted to put that mask on someone to carry on the legacy that you've worked so hard to establish. And you've also mentioned this man is very loyal to you.
That's correct. I want to put it on a man. And needless to say, this is a man of men, believe me. T.A. was far from being anything near that.
A high vertical suplex, and Jason Wacker.
Look at the wrestling ability. There it is. That's it. That's the end of the road right there. Then that man gets him up, it's all over.
Tremendous strength, and another victory for Mr. Wrestling 2. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with a special look at Steve
beautiful,
Dr. Death
beautiful,
Williams
beautiful.
And a visit with the Rock and Roll Express after this word from the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
That's my man.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, every week it seems that Mid-South Wrestling gets even greater. And here next week, Steve Dr. Death Williams, a great four-time Wrestling All-American from the Oklahoma University, will be with us here in person next week. But we've got a special look at him. And after we look at that, we're going to be with the Rock and Roll Express. So it's an exciting segment indeed. Let's go now to Oklahoma City, a great 14,000 capacity crowd on April the 8th. Steve Dr. Death Williams in action. And it's narrated by Cowboy Bill Watts.
Stanley Abel at the University of Oklahoma's loss was our gain when Steve Dr. Death William, four-time All-American heavyweight at University of Oklahoma, graduated and came into the ranks of pro wrestling. Steve Dr. Death Williams, known for his brutal strength, his bruising style, not his finesse. Oklahoma University has felt his loss because they haven't had that home run. You know, at the end of every amateur match, the heavyweight division, that's the main event. That's what the people come to see. And it's tough when you have to face 6 points going against you. When you had Doc, you were assured of always winning. Look at this powerful man, the starting guard at the University of Oklahoma for Barry Switzer. He's massive and awesome. And Jerry Gray at the sold-out Myriad Center in beautiful Oklahoma City, he says, I don't want anymore. He's just intimidated completely by Dr. Death, as many heavyweights were through his college career. Doc has that intensity, just like hitting a brick wall. Steve Dr. Death Williams, who helped to destroy the national champion University of Texas team, blocking up the middle for Marcus Dupree in that great victory 2 years ago at Dallas. You can see why. He's a team leader. He had a lot of enthusiasm. He never quit. He believes in himself. It's been a great joy for me to be able to coach him into the ranks of pro wrestling, to show him some of the things that was fortunate enough to help me become one of the top stars in wrestling. And everybody's excited about the return of Steve Dr. Death Williams. Hacksaw, Butch Reed, Nikolai Volkoff, Crusher Khrushchev, these men don't want to face Steve Dr. Death Williams. King Kong Bundy, 420 pounds. The doc physically destroyed him, picked him up and stampeded him. The only person I've ever seen to pick Bundy up, run across the ring with him, stampede him. Look at Jerry Gray. He's trying to find a way to climb out. Doc is just playing with him. Oklahoma City's been the scene of some fantastic battles. It's on fire, the Myriad Center. It's been excitement. There's Steve Dr. Death, arm whipping to the turnbuckle. Doc's got him up. Doc's got him up. Looks like he's going for the Oklahoma Stampede. Look at the poise, the power. He knows he has his man. He knows he's going to plant him. He almost puts him 3 feet below the ring. Jerry Gray just happy to be alive. Dr. Death, another victory for the All-American.
One of the most exciting events in all of wrestling is the Superdome Wrestling Extravaganza. This year, because the World's Fair is being held in New Orleans, a special Superdome will be held on June the 16th. Tickets are now on sale at all Ticketmaster outlets in New Orleans, plus the Superdome. We want to encourage you to get your tickets now because it's going to be a very exciting night indeed. And one thing that we're doing very, very special for all the young ladies, unmarried, 18 years of age or more, win a date with the Rock and Roll Express. I know that we've got a lot of entries and a lot of exciting things have come of this. Just the small announcement that we made last week, and guys know you're looking forward to it. Chauffeur-driven limousine, and we do want to talk about how we're going to pick the winners, because one thing we want to clarify, we're going to have a lot of entries. You all are not going to be responsible for picking the entries, but I know, Ricky, you mentioned to me that you've seen some of the pictures. They look pretty nice.
That's right, Ross. You know, I've read some of the letters, looked at some of the pictures, and I'm just glad I'm not the one who has to pick, because the brother has a lot of pretty ones out there, and you can see right here behind us. We're going to have us a good time and party down. Right.
All right. Well, you know, we're going to have a big date in the Superdome. Ladies, I want to stress to you, everyone is eligible to enter as long as you're unmarried, 18 years of age or more. Send a quality picture, the very best picture that you possibly can, and in 25 words or less, why you'd like to go on the Super Date in the Superdome with the Rock and Roll Express. And mail those entries to Superdate in care of Mid-South Wrestling, Bixby, Oklahoma, 74008. And chauffeur-driven limousine, round-trip airfare, and I know you guys are notorious, if I might use that word, for partying. It's going to be a big party.
You ain't kidding, Jim. It's going to be first class, too. The limousine, everything's going to be a good time. I'm just happy to be part of it because all the girls will make sure it'll be a good time.
You know, I can think of a lot of great places to party, but I really can't think of any place greater to party than at the Superdome, Bourbon Street, and a lot of exciting things can happen.
That's right, Ross. You know, I have a lot of good times down in New Orleans, especially at the Superdome. But, brother, when it comes to young ladies, I mean ladies of the 80s, woo! I'm talking about good times. Because me and Robert both, brother, we like to party. And we're going to have ourselves a good time, I can tell you that.
Well, there you hear it at the Super Date at the Superdome. We'll tell you more about it as the weeks progress. Be sure and send those quality pictures. Send those entries in now, and we'll be back with more Mid-South wrestling action after this word from the network. This event, one fall, our television time remaining. In the red corner, the rugged Oriental star, Masao Ito. And his opponent, 238 pounds, Virginia Beach, Virginia, Magnum T.A.
It'll be Magnum T.A. going against the Oriental star with a great one-loss record, Masao Ito, here on our final match of Mid-South Wrestling. Referee Ron West will be the third man in the ring, generating a tremendous amount of excitement, and we want to thank all the young ladies for those entries to the Super Date and the Superdome. Magnum T.A. with that arm bar, and he's got it firmly entrenched on that arm of Masao Ito, a man that is a really a lethal weapon. Fireman's carry takeover. Holding on to the arm, Magnum T.A. A young man that has really come into his own here in Mid-South Wrestling to become one of the top heavyweights in the world. The number one contender for the North American Championship, Magnum T.A. going against a rugged opponent. A man that can put you down for the three count in many, many ways, including his feet and hands, a martial arts expert. Magnum T.A. with that tackle. T.A. surveying it. You know, Cowboy Bill Watts brought up a great point here last week. All the rigorous training, and I had the privilege of being on the inside, as it were, to some of that tremendous training that Mr. Wrestling 2 at that time put Magnum T.A. through. One thing perhaps that Magnum T.A. got out of that more than anything was the tremendous intensity that you have to be a top-flight competitor. Dropkick by Magnum T.A. Arm drag takeover. T.A. on the offensive thus far in this final bout of another exciting hour of Mid-South wrestling action. Some tremendous action here today. We've seen the Rock and Roll Express, the new Mid-South Tag Team Champions, victorious. And that unbelievable, simply unbelievable incident with a junkyard dog with yellow paint from head to toe at the hands of Cornette and the Midnight Express, and especially Hacksaw Butch Reed. Masao Ito trying to take back over on Magnum T.A. Ito with a headbutt, a vicious headbutt. Ito makes every part of his body a weapon. Ito going for that leg drop, and Magnum T.A. showing the great quickness that he has, moving out of the way. Arm whipping to the corner, and Magnum T.A. miscalculation there. The Japanese very adeptly moved out of the way. Thunderous chop there. Karate kick to the head. That karate kick to the head, and now he's got that Oriental claw, the version of the claw hold that he brought with him from the Orient. A tremendous, tremendous hold that he has used upon occasion to really inflict some punishment. He's used it to the throat. You have seen what that has done to many of his opponents, and now he's using it to the forehead. More traditional, just as deadly, and goes right back to the claw. Ron West, one of the great referees in the wrestling business, getting a very, very close look to make sure that Masao Ito does not break any rules in this particular maneuver, headbutt. And Magnum T.A. has been lacerated from the karate kick and from that claw hold. Magnum T.A. has been severely lacerated here on this final match during this awesome hour of Mid-South wrestling action. Masao Ito going right back to the claw hold, and he has been relentless the last few minutes with that particular maneuver. Magnum T.A. in great condition. Karate kick. Another karate kick. Headbutt. Ito. I have never seen Ito any more vicious than we are seeing him now in this match against the number one contender. Our packed house here at the Irish McNeil Boys Club, sitting in the hushed silence as Magnum T.A. has been severely lacerated at the hands of the Oriental star, Masao Ito. Referee Ron West with a two count. Ladies and gentlemen, this match was one fall or television time remaining. We don't have a great deal of time left in this hour. The Magnum T.A. reaching down the fourth quarter, but Ito cuts him right off. Ladies and gentlemen, I've just been notified that we have just under 3 minutes of television time remaining. Magnum T.A. is in a bad, bad way against Masao Ito, a relentless Masao Ito. more relentless than we have ever seen him since he has been on the Mid-South wrestling scene. And Magnum T.A. will... I tell you, Magnum T.A. showing some tremendous courage because he has been brutalized by this man from the Orient. I mentioned earlier that he could hurt you in a lot of ways, his feet, his hands, and of course his head. And he's got the claw, and he has really got it wrenched in, and T.A.'s fighting back. Magnum T.A. trying to fight back against Masao Ito. Ito with another karate kick to the head. 2 minutes left, ladies and gentlemen, and very frankly, I don't know how much more Magnum T.A. can stand of this tremendous punishment. Masao Ito. Ito's going outside. He's climbing over. Ito, if he comes off the top and gets him. Terry Taylor has just come to ringside. Terry Taylor's there. He's exhorting his good friend, Magnum T.A. on. The crowd's getting behind him. Terry Taylor's there. Magnum T.A. Belly to belly. He's got the belly to belly suplex. It came from nowhere. 1, 2, 3. Magnum T.A. with a great victory. A great victory. I'll tell you what, coming from behind, he came from behind some tremendous fourth quarter effort, if you will. Badly lacerated. Magnum T.A. A tremendous match and a great victory for Magnum T.A. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been a great hour of Mid-South wrestling action. Don't forget, next week, Hacksaw Jim Duggan will be back. Grizzly Smith, our matchmaker, is negotiating with a bout. Hacksaw Jim Duggan against Crusher Cruise Ship. We'll have to see if that can transpire in their negotiations. Also, Kerry Von Erich, the great star from Dallas, will be here next week. Also, Steve Dr. Death Williams will be here. And don't forget, ladies, if you're 18 years of age or older and you're not married, be sure and send a good picture, the best picture you can in 25 words or less, why you want to go on the Super Date at the Superdome. Remember, the great Superdome coming up June 16th. Tickets are on sale now in New Orleans at all Ticketmaster outlets, and also the Superdome. It's going to be a great, great Superdome extravaganza. So for my colleague Joel Watts and all of our Mid-South Wrestling crew, I'm Jim Ross saying goodbye, everybody.